Greetings, humans. Spinning Mantis here with the next episode of The Long Dark Stalker. Thanks for joining me. So today we're going to go out on the lake and try to get some of the meat that's out there. There's wolf meat out there, deer meat out there, a couple places we haven't explored on the lake yet. So we'll do that. Another floating icicle. Could even possibly go looking for the prepper cache today. It's a possibility. Depending on the wolf configuration. Looking pretty quiet on the lake this morning. There's one deer carcass we definitely wanted to get to. So we've checked these two fishing huts. Is that a dead wolf or is that a dead deer? Or is that something else altogether? It's just some snow. You know nothing. Snow. Still some live wolves. I've checked all three of these. There's two wolves out there. Should be a deer carcass. I mean, does the deer carcass disappear that quickly? I think we gotta try our old plan again. Get the deer out in front of us. Try to take a shot of the feasting puppy. Don't have that many bullets left, only three. All right, buddy. Meet your wolfy friends. There really should be one more carcass out there. I can't believe it disappeared overnight. I mean, does that mean the wolves, like, totally ate it? Maybe because they didn't interact with it, it despawned? I just don't know. What does wolves get to? One of them just passed away, apparently. Rest in peace, wolf. Ready then.
Whew, this pack is getting kind of heavy.
Again, we'll leave the wolf meat. Because we are not struggling for food, and it can give us the parasites. Okay. Another cabin that's really doesn't have much anything in it. Yep. Not much of anything. Okay, I think we should check out all the huts. Okay. Yeah, well, I just gotta suppose that if you don't interact with the deer carcass, the wolves will eat all of it and you won't even see it. Just lots of newspaper out here. All right. Kind of creepy. Let's go check for the pepper cache. There's Wolfgang. 2 of them. Like they appeared out of nowhere. Yep, we were just there. Just want to make sure and orient myself the way I knew how to line it up. Weather's holding up. There yet. Goes way back. Way back. I can't remember if I ever found this one before, but once you get up here, you just take a look along the ridge line, and then as well as keep your eyes peeled for like under the trees. Yeah. Don't think we found it. Anyway, no prepper cache. Running down a snowy mountain. Yeah, those look interesting. Looks like I pulled off the throttle just in time there. Me in Stalker mode, we need all the resources. We'll gladly take all these. These are for arrows, the birch saplings. I think they increased it. They used to come in little packs of three rather than like five like that, which is better because, you know, arrows, you need a bunch of them. And then the maple is for the bow. Yeah, saplings are actually pretty amazing survival tools. There's a lot of things you can do with them, you know, as opposed to like a dead branch or an old grown branch. Saplings are like very flexible as well as being strong. They have a good spring to them. Use them for traps, building shelters, so like you can weave them. If you actually can find a place where you can find a bunch of saplings. Even, you know, like skinny little trees. Less than... You know, if you could put your two hands together around it, like smaller than that. But they can still be pretty tall, up to like, you know, 6, 7, 8 feet. but they're still like real skinny and like super young trees. You can take things like that. Let's say no more than like, I'm trying to think of the correct diameter, say. Like a little bigger than a bottle cap. Anyway, you can get those and you can just weave them together and create like a dome. You can get like 4 to 6 of those that are 4 to 6 feet tall. You can kind of weave them together to make the frame of a dome and then fill the rest in with other stuff. But yeah, with flexible stuff. Then you just weave the rest in. Seven hours. I need to do some cooking soon. There we go. A little pep in her step for a second. All right, guns away when you're indoors. Oh, it's super bright. Let us. Do we even have, No, we don't have any raw stuff. That was a good little break. I'm gonna go ahead and drop off the other stuff. There we go. I'm gonna drop the stick somewhere too. Cool. Very cool. Adventures. 7 hours, we've got good energy left. We can search for prepper cache that I've definitely never found. Maybe it's our lucky day. Oh, hi, dear. How you doing? It's like right up there, straight ahead, somewhere in that ridge. I mean, it sounds bad, but it's not really. Deer at. Right. More wolf and deer games. There's a wolf right over here. Really? Okay. That's fine. See, I think you're just supposed to take a left over here and kind of check out down on that ridge. Be somewhere up there. I don't think it's supposed to be over there. No, no, I think it's supposed to be up top, top, top. Here, which we will go check out anyway. Just in case it is supposed to be up top, top, top here. There's a whole bunch of ones I've never found. So yeah, like somewhere down there. Is that it? No. I think I've actually seen that before and been like, oh my god, is that it? It's just a tree. Drunk. Yeah. Unless I'm looking in the wrong place, I don't think it's there. So, give the top a little look, just in case. Yeah, then you got this jagged face. That is it. We have walked the entire edge. Over there, there's just rabbits and wolves. Could be good to start some. And I missed again. It's crazy. Well, that's not how I planned that. 6 hours of daylight. Definitely running low on bullets. Could head to the trapper's cabin. Five hours, we got enough wind for it. I don't think we're super overburdened at all. Really not carrying that much food around. So let's do that. Oh, there's a big box of ammo. The trapper's cabin. I am probably a better shot in real life than I am in this game. Haven't shot a weapon in a long time though. Got my Boy Scout riflery badge. But that was, you know, last century. That seems like a wolf up there. And this is my last. Bullet. Where you at? There you at. If he goes away, ooh, actually scared me. The way it, game kind of froze for a second. Does that sometimes when not loading? Okay. Shoot. Alright, let's check out the tunnel collapse. Oh, got one more bullet. Okay. I don't see any blood trail, so it's my last bullet. Made it count. Okay. That hurt. That hurt bad.
No. I am not ready to die.
Okay. That's kind of bad. Kind of bad. I need to bust it and get to the cabin. Might be a good time for a stim. Let's go. As a friend of mine used to say, let's go bananas. Oh shoot. We really need to just sprint this out. Wind that's slowing us down so bad. We will certainly die if we're caught. Oh my goodness, we made it. Oh wow. That was super intense. We really almost died there.
Man, I am too tired to think straight.
Okay. Here we are. We made it.
I wonder if I can drop any of this gear.
Wow. A lot of stuff there. Yeah, this place is usually stocked. One rifle cartridge. Better than none rifle cartridge. Two rifle cartridge. Alrighty, let's crack the safe. Somewhere right after 40. Wasn't really paying attention. More like 39. Okay. Thirty-nine, something like 57. alone. Come on. Wow. That was an annoying combination. Alright, MRE and rifle rounds. Perfect together. So we got 2 hours. I don't see why we shouldn't.
I can barely walk with this much gear.
True. Do 1 hour rest. Do 1 hour research. Nice. Well, that is going to be a good place to end this episode. So happy that you can join me. It also makes me really happy when you like and subscribe. And I hope you join me next time for more of The Long Dark Stalker. That is going to be all for now. Spinning Mantis out. Namaste.